I know.
Well, finally, we're in Hawaii.
Finally.
Finally. Good. God is great.
Okay, this is where I have to tell you why we are in Hawaii. Our lifelong friends, Mike and Karen, who have been talking about moving to Hawaii for 20 years, finally moved to Hawaii. This is us pulling into their driveway and seeing it for the very first time.
Oh, I love this tree.
Look at this.
Oh my God,
it's
I love
this.
Wow.
Look at all the fans. What in the heck are those?
That's the flower. This is the flower from the yeah, that's the flower. This is the neighbor's talking about.
There's the plants. The philodendron is pulling out.
Ooh.
Yep, it's probably overgrown in there.
Oh yeah. We are here! Oh yeah, and these are my rainbow palms. My favorite thing on the planet.
Not called rainbow palms at all.
They're not. Though. They're called something else, but I call them rainbow palm. Look at, I have them all over too. I've got
it's
one up
so
there.
So pretty.
Look at the hibiscus.
And you've got these
king palms. And got a little bit of mimosa tree going on. Oh please, there's so many flipping plants on this property.
Look at this mimosa.
They're 100 pounds easy.
Yeah, when they fall, dude.
The big ones like that.
It's scary.
Oh. We don't want to go under, just like durian tree, right? We don't want to get durian hit your head.
Bottom part of Mike and Karen's property, and just check out all the different plants. There's supposed to be a mango tree down here, and this morning we discovered a gigantic avocado tree. Check this out. Let's see if we can find them. Now we're gonna go down here.
Honey, we gotta go to the grocery store right now.
What are these?
These are limes.
Oh, no kidding.
Well, we have lime and lemon.
Okay.
I have no
I
idea.
I love that. See, okay. This kind of mango there.
There you go.
All right.
See him right here?
That is definitely a tree that's of a mango-ness.
It might be a little too ripe.
I know. Look at how they like to make the tree. It's so funny.
Yeah, there's another couple of
them. It's an orange one up there.
Yeah. That one looks like it's perfect, ripe. Doesn't it?
But maybe not.
I don't. There's maybe a really pretty orange one right up there.
Uh-huh.
Is that done?
Is that ripe enough?
Yep, this is almost ripe.
Get that orange one.
I don't know how you get there.
Just jump.
Yeah, but you know how sweet it would be? You get like a little screw. Yeah, the lemon's over here.
We've made it to a fantastic beach. It's our first beach on this trip. And I thought you might appreciate this beach back here. Let's go check it out. I'm planning to get in it, so hang tight.
Woo!
I love it. The watercolor is really nice.
black lava that just goes into the ocean is so cool. But I tell you, it's hot on your feet. Right now my feet are boiling. But it's interesting how you got so much of this black lava, but yet you have white sand. So I'm not exactly sure how that happens. But there are black sand beaches in Hawaii, and hopefully we'll go to one. It's pretty cool. Black sand. So stay tuned. That's it. So we have found the Queen's Path. So we're gonna check this out. It's a cenote.
Okay, yes.
No, how do you say it?
Cenote.
Cenote. Yes. This is so cool. It's fresh water right by the ocean right here. Check this out.
Sam's gonna go. You hang on to Sam.
It is really deep.
How deep it's is it? High tide, so it's not. It's just when you jump in, keep your feet up.
Keep my feet up.
Yeah. Thanks, Sam. I'm gonna go on the other side if she needs to come up.
Okay.
I'm thinking in Mexico, we went. There's like cenotes like this when they're like.
Yeah. Okay,
Kyle.
Hey.
Kyle. She likes the cold water, I think.
Yes.
Honey. Honey.
This is nice. Oh my God. Much better than beach.
How is it, Mike?
Chilly.
I bet it's a trip though that it's fresh water, huh?
Yeah.
So good.
Okay, so we're gonna go underneath this cave here. So
where?
Watch this.
Okay, I can come. Oh, sorry.
There we go.
Is there?
Okay, get her just off the beaten path and. Mm-hmm.
You are brave. You are brave. Okay. Cannot leave you in all the way by yourself.
No.
There was something else.
Okay, so there we go. And look at the camera. Yeah.
You think I'm loco?
I think you're loco.
This beautiful private house up by the palm trees is owned by Earl E. Bakken, who's the inventor of the pacemaker. He worked in his garage in Minneapolis to invent the first wearable, battery-powered pacemaker, then went on to create the world's largest medical device company. Unfortunately, he died about 2 years ago, and the house is up for sale if you have $50 million.
Another beautiful house, and it's kind of a Bali or Sumatra style, Wee Wee says. And this is their view. Okay. Amazing place. here's a great little place somebody owns. This would be their view. Private beach. And he's just collected stuff, it looks like, from all over the beach. How cool is this? Your little paradise.
Every time I'm down there, you make me smile.